Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 23A, Example 2. In this example, we want to solve the quadratic inequality 17x plus 5 is greater than or equal to a negative 6x squared by using the sine graph of factors, write our answer in interval notation, and graph the solution step. In step 1, we want to write the quadratic inequality in standard form. The standard form for a quadratic inequality is just like the standard form for quadratic equations, where we have ax squared plus bx plus c either less than or greater than 0. The reason we are doing this is 0 is our magic number. It is the only number that separates the negatives from the positives. If an expression is greater than 0, then there is no doubt that its sign is positive. Likewise, if it is less than 0, its sign is negative. We cannot say this about any other number. Since we are working with inequalities, this idea will come in handy. With this technique, we will be looking at the sign of a number to determine if it is a solution or not. It looks like we need to move the negative 6x squared to the other side. We can do this by doing the inverse operation and add 6x squared to both sides. This will give us 17x plus 5 plus 6x squared is greater than or equal to negative 6x squared plus 6x squared. This will simplify to be 6x squared plus 17x plus 5 is greater than or equal to 0. In step 2, we want to set up what we found in step 1 as a quadratic equation and solve it by factoring to get the boundary points. The boundary points will mark off where the quadratic expression is equal to 0. This is like the crossover point, since 0 is neither positive nor negative. Our equation will be 6x squared plus 17x plus 5 equals 0. This trinomial will factor as 2x plus 5 times 3x plus 1. And we still have it set equal to 0. Using the zero product principle, we can set each factor equal to 0 and get 2x plus 5 equals 0, or 3x plus 1 equals 0. In the first linear equation, we can do the inverse and subtract 5 from both sides and get 2x plus 5 minus 5 equals 0 minus 5, which will simplify to be 2x equals negative 5. Dividing both sides by that 2, we get 2x over 2 equals a negative 5 over 2, which simplifies to be x equals a negative 5 over 2. In the second linear equation, we can subtract 1 from both sides and get 3x plus 1 minus 1 equals 0 minus 1, which simplifies to be 3x equals negative 1. Dividing both sides by 3, we get 3x over 3 equals negative 1 over 3, which simplifies to be x equals a negative 1 over 3. So it looks like we have two boundary points, negative 5 halves and negative 1 third. In step 3, we want to use the boundary points from step 2 to mark off test intervals on the number line and list all the factors found in step 2. Here we have marked off our boundary points of a negative 5 halves and negative 1 third. Note that we are using closed holes at the two points because our original inequality included where it is equal to 0. Note that our boundary points mark off three sections on the graph, negative infinity to negative 5 halves, negative 5 halves to negative 1 third, and negative 1 third to infinity. We will list the two factors that we found, 2x plus 5 and 3x plus 1, on the side. In step 4, we need to find the sign of every factor in every interval. When we do this, we can choose any point in an interval to represent that interval. Once we choose this value, we will plug it into each factor and determine if the sign of that factor is either positive or negative. Let's go ahead and choose negative 4 from the first interval of negative infinity to negative 5 halves. Plugging a negative 4 into the first factor, we get 2 times negative 4 plus 5 equals negative 3. Since we got a negative number, the sign of that factor in that interval is negative. Now let's plug negative 4 into our other factor and get 3 times negative 4 plus 1 equals negative 11. So it looks like we have another negative factor in that interval. Moving to the second interval of negative 5 halves to negative 1 third, let's go ahead and choose negative 1 to plug in. This will give us 2 times negative 1 plus 5 equals 3 for the top factor, which means that factor is positive for that interval. Plugging negative 1 into the second factor, we get 3 times negative 1 plus 1 equals negative 2, so this factor is also negative in that second interval. Let's check out that last interval of negative 1 third to infinity. Let's choose 0 to plug into 2x plus 5. That gives us 2 times 0 plus 5 equals 5. Since 5 is positive, this factor is positive in that last interval. Plugging the 0 into 3x plus 1, we get 3 times 0 plus 1 equals 1, which means this factor is also positive in that last interval. In step 5, we want to use the signs found in step 4 and determine the sign of the overall quadratic function in each interval. In the first interval of negative infinity to negative 5 halves, we would have a negative times a negative, so the sign of that product of those two factors is positive. In the second interval of negative 5 halves to negative 1 third, we would have a positive times a negative, so the sign of the product of those two factors is negative. In the third interval of negative 1 third to infinity, we would have a positive times a positive, so the sign of that product of those two factors is positive. In step 6, we want to write the solution set in interval notation and graph it. Remember that the original inequality in standard form is 6x squared plus 17x plus 5 is greater than or equal to 0. To be greater than or equal to 0 means that quadratic has to be positive or equal to 0. Looking at the bottom line, it looks like there are two intervals where the quadratic is positive. The first one, which is negative infinity to negative 5 halves, and the third one, which is negative 1 third to infinity. Since we're including the endpoints, this will be a closed interval and we will use box ends to indicate this. So our final answer for the interval notation is negative infinity to the closed end of negative 5 halves, union with the closed end of negative 1 third to infinity. Last, we need to graph this. The graph will look like the interval notation. We will have a boxed end at negative 5 halves and shade everything to the left of that, and a boxed end at negative 1 third and shade everything to the right of that for our final answer for the graph.